Hi guys, I'm Susan and this is episode 9 of Fresh Takes and Mistakes, a new vlog where we're going to discuss weight loss, fitness, and all the messy mind stuff in between. Sorry I'm posting this so late tonight. I've been moving. I don't know if you can see my walls are a little bit more bare than they were before, but I've been moving and it is real. I've never moved like a whole house before and this is But I did want to go ahead and post because I had an experience today that I thought I should really discuss on this week's episode, and I think that you guys might appreciate it. Today I want to talk about, again, something I experienced today, taking breaks. So I know that it may seem counterproductive and it may seem weird to think that you need to take breaks from your health and fitness journey in order to be successful, but hear me out, okay? Because today I got really down on myself and I wanted to go to the gym and my mood was just crap and it was ridiculous. So I came home and I had every intention of continuing to pack, which for anybody who's done that is quite physically strenuous and of course mentally exhausting as well. So I sit down on my couch and I'm like, I'm just done. It's like 5:30 and I'm like, this is just ridiculous. So I sit down on my couch and before I know it, I'm eating like Tostitos and like cheese dip and peanut butter cookies and drinking a Coke and like just watching Crazy Ex-Girlfriend on Netflix. And I think if I had done that a year ago, I would have felt really super nasty guilty. And you know, on some days even now, probably would have gone and tried to take a bike ride to burn off at least some of the calories that I took in. But today, and I think more recently, I've been realizing that in order for your health journey to be successful, you do need to take breaks from it. And when I say that, I mean taking breaks from like physically tracking your food or physical exercise, but you're still working on your health, I think, by taking the break and your self-care by taking that break, because your body and your mind need time to relax and readjust and, you know, they need that care. I want to talk a little bit about each aspect of that because you're talking about taking a break from number one, food tracking, and number two, exercise. And I think the bigger portion there is the food tracking for me personally, because exercise just really gives me like a lot of endorphins. And if I don't do it enough, then I kind of get feeling a little bit down. But I will get to the point about taking breaks from exercise as well, because I've had to teach myself to do that too. So I think that the big reasons why you would want to take breaks from food tracking would be, number one, that you can start to feel like you're in a prison and you're really restricted and you're not getting the things that you're used to getting or enough sugar or whatever, and you start to feel like you're just like never going to get those things again, or like you're having to give up this whole like food group or these foods or whatever, this whole, honestly, for somebody who was like me, kind of a whole part of your life. Because when I was at 327 pounds, 319 pounds, I was legit, that was my whole night was spent laying on the couch watching TV and eating. And I know that some of you have seen my post about shoveling cookie dough into my mouth by the spoonful. Again, I will say, anybody who doesn't like cookie dough, I don't understand. And I will still eat spoonfuls of cookie dough some days. But my point is that you can get to feel like you're a little bit in a prison when you are constantly tracking your food. And it can be a little bit obsessive, for me at least. I know some other people do experience this. It can be a little bit obsessive, because you're like, oh, I don't want to go 10 calories over, or I've got 30 calories left, I need to eat those. And when you get to that point, when you're eating 1,200 calories a day, or that's your intake, or whatever the case may be, and you're looking at 10 or 20 calories over or under as being like a problem, even up to, honestly, for me, like 50 calories or 100 calories is not a big deal to go over or stay under. Mostly over, for the record, because I do quite a bit of physical exercise. But I mean, under as well, I don't think it's the end of the world if you're under by 100 calories. However, according to MyFitnessPal, and I do believe this, if you're eating less than 100 or 1,000 calories a day, you probably should be eating more. So being obsessive and also feeling like a prison is two reasons why I would say you would want to take a break from the exercise or rather the food tracking. But the other thing I would say too is that it helps me to remember how much better my body feels when I'm eating clean and when I'm tracking my food if I take a break from it. So if I go on vacation, or if I go away for the weekend, or if I'm home for the weekend or whatever, and I eat junk or fast food or a lot of sugar and not a lot of protein or whatever, like I can feel the difference in my body. And I think that probably is something that grows over time. But I can definitely feel Monday morning like a food hangover if I've eaten a bunch of crap all weekend and my body's like, oh my God, I need some protein, please feed me. And then a lot of water. I don't know if any of you have this problem, but when I'm home on the weekends, I have a much harder time drinking water. So it's something I'm working on. But anyway, I would say definitely helps to remind you how much better your body feels when you do track the food and when you are eating cleaner if you take a break from it. And my suggestion for taking those breaks is that you set a time that you're going to do that. So say if you do it one weekend day or Friday nights or whatever. For me, because I do a lot of exercise, I really kind of just do breaks on the weekends, Saturday and Sunday, or I try to do Saturday and Sunday. This is Fresh Takes and Mistakes, and sometimes that becomes Friday, Saturday, Sunday, Monday, Tuesday. It's the whole thing. So I would definitely say that it helps with, you know, the obsession over it and feeling like you're in a prison, and then also just reminding you how much your body feels. The only other thing that I would say too is that if you are taking regular breaks from food tracking, then when you do slip up, you're not in that mindset of, I had a cupcake, now I need to have pizza and candy and chips and salsa and blah, 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 whatever else you're going to eat. I know I talk about chips and salsa a lot. It's like my thing. So I think if you are taking those regular breaks and you know that you can have those things on that break day or the weekend day or whatever meal you're going to have or whatever, and I say cheat meal sometimes, I say cheat day sometimes because it's an understood term, but personally, I don't think that cheat is the right word because you're fueling your body, you're feeding your body and you're enjoying food, and I don't think there's anything wrong with that. So anyway, if you know that you have those days to look forward to, you don't feel like you are needing to eat everything that you will ever want to eat and not be able to eat on good days or whatever when you have one slip up. So now I'm going to get into the exercise, and I think that a lot of you do know why it's important to take a break from exercise, but it can get really hard, especially if you enjoy exercise, if you have, if you feel like you have depression, anxiety, anything like that. Exercise really, really helps me personally. I do struggle with depression and anxiety, and it helps me personally to feel better and, you know, just have a better outlook on life and be more positive and enjoy life more to exercise. But that can, number one, become an obsession too. It can become excessive. And the other thing too is that your body needs to recover. I can't tell you how many days I've gotten up and been ready to go to the gym and wanted to go to the gym and my legs hurt or my back hurts or whatever. And it's like, okay, am I going to go to the gym and struggle through this because I'm up and I'm ready? Or am I going to let my body take what it needs and take that rest and whatever? And I would say the better thing to do on those days when you're feeling like that is to give your body the rest. Now, I'm not saying lay around the house all day that day. I'm talking about when you weight train, or even if you're doing any really strenuous cardio or you're out of shape and you do cardio, it can really get that way on days after that if it's not something you're used to doing. So I'm not saying lay around the house all day, please, still take your walks or, do whatever you would typically do in a day, take your dog for a walk, whatever the case may be, but don't push yourself on those days. Have a rest day. And if you do decide to lay on the couch and binge watch Netflix all day, then, that is fine too. But your body definitely needs time to recover and to rest, and you can get burnt out if you don't take days off of working out. For me, I will say that the last time I tried to lose weight when I was unsuccessful, I would go 5 days a week in a row or whatever and try to work out, and it just got to be really exhausting. And then you take one day off, and then one day turns into six, and then 10, and then 12, and then 2 months later and you're just haven't been to the gym at all. So I would say if you are taking regular breaks from working out, then you probably won't get burnt out as quickly. The last thing I'm going to talk about, and it goes with the taking a break from exercise and taking a break from food tracking, is going to be your mental breaks. Because for me personally, I think that the food tracking can get to be a little bit exhausting. And because I obsess over it and the calories and the numbers and all that stuff, so that can get to be a little mentally exhausting and I can get mentally down on myself. So if I don't take breaks from the food tracking, that is a problem for my mental health, but also for exercise, because I do tend to obsess and question and try to go too hard and all that stuff. And it does require some brain power, even though you're working your body more so. It requires quite a bit for me, brain power working out as well. So I would say your body needs rest and it needs time to regroup and it needs, you know, it needs a break and it needs self-care, but your mind also does as well. And sometimes that self-care is spending the day in your house cleaning. Sometimes that self-care is binge watching Netflix all day and not having to think about anything. Sometimes it's getting a massage. Sometimes it's taking a bath. Sometimes it's journaling, whatever the case may be, but it's not always going to the gym. And sometimes it is going to the gym. So if for you, you need to take a break from the gym or from food tracking for your self-care, for your mental health, I think it's important to do so and to not feel bad about it, because then you're counterproductive because you're feeling bad about it. So you're putting stress on your brain anyway. And I think that your brain is important. So I think it's definitely good for you guys and for me, of course, to take a break from those things for my mental health. So I hope you guys enjoyed this episode. I definitely had a personal experience with this today. My wife was telling me to go ahead and take a break, and I just really didn't want to because I felt like I wasn't going to feel productive and then I would feel bad about myself. And I didn't take a break the whole day, but I did give myself an hour or two to just kind of relax and eat crap and watch TV or whatever. So, and I will tell you, I felt a lot better afterwards. So enjoy your breaks, drink some water, and I'll see you guys next week.